As a coach and physio, it is one thing that I see so many people doing wrong leading into a race that I'm sure costs them not getting out their full potential. And that is a bit sad, because in a way this is the easiest way to get a better result, because you basically have to train less to get better, but it can still be really hard to get it right. So in this video I'll go through the science of tapering, and by the end of it share an example of how I design a tapering period, and hopefully this will help you get out your full potential on the race day. That short run was actually a part of a tapering phase that I'm currently in myself. But what is a taper in the first place? A taper before a running race is a period where runners reduce their training to help their bodies recover and prepare for the race. The taper period should allow the muscles to heal and the energy levels to build up, and also help you get mentally ready to push hard on race day. The goal is to arrive at the start line feeling rested and ready to perform your very best. And studies have shown that a good taper period really can make a difference. In this study here, just a 7-day taper improved 5K performance by 3%. So if you run around a 20-minute 5K, a well-planned and executed taper could be the difference between running a 20-minute and 1-second 5K and a 19:35. That's pretty huge, and this is like the one thing in endurance performance that actually takes less effort to make you better. But still, as mentioned, many people seem to not take advantage of this, and I have a theory of why. As mentioned, I'm currently in a tapering period myself. In 7 days I will run a pretty brutal ultramarathon, so I'm planning my tapering here towards the race, trying to do it right this time. But I for sure have done it wrong so many times. Many of us runners are ambitious people who want to perform well, and the mindset all of us have is that the harder we work and the more effort we put into our training and the more we can train, the better the result will be. And this is in a way true, as long as we don't overtrain and overdo it. But the last period leading into a race is so different. When I was going to run the toughest ultramarathon I have ran so far, a 100 km race in the mountains with over 7,000 meters of vertical gain, I just 7 days before the race ran my last tough long run, a 43 km run with lots of vertical gain. I was so ambitious leading into this race and wanted to push my training hard as close to the race as possible. But in hindsight, I should have just skipped that session, because 7 days for everything in your body to fully recover and heal from a longer tough run like that is not enough. And I still felt some aches and that my body wasn't completely recovered and ready when I towed that start line to that ultra. So I try to learn from that and not let my high ambition get in the way of me showing up fresh on race day and ready to race. So I have planned a pretty easy last 7 days here, but how long should a taper really be? I would love to sit here and say that a taper period should be 10 days and that is optimal for everyone and has been shown in several studies that it works best. But as with most things with training, it is not that simple and no exact science. We are all different and we respond in different ways to the training stimuli. But after reading this review of the relevant studies on the subject, they found that 7 to 21 days as a taper period had all shown positive effects on the performance. So I think that the taper period is individual and also has to do with what kind of race you're going to run. In general, I would recommend a longer tapering period the longer the race are. So for example, if you're running a marathon, at least 2 weeks with lowered volume I think is a good idea. And for a 5K, 7 days should work fine. Like in this study that I referred to earlier, they got a 3% boost in a 5K from just a 7-day tapering period. But I also think you should take into consideration how important this particular race is to you. Because if you have a lot of races all the time that you have long tapering periods for, that will lead you to do a lot of less training overall and will hinder your long-term progress. So just pick the most important races to you to have a proper taper period leading into it is my recommendation. Also, a really important thing to consider when you plan out your training is what you do before the tapering period starts. This review of the literature concluded that the tapering applied in conjunction with pre-taper overload training seems to be more conductive to maximize performance gains. So what you want to do is to make sure that you train really hard before you start easing off the training, to basically break down your body a bit and get that super compensation when your body recovers during the tapering phase and get stronger and better. Also, when it comes to how much you should reduce your training, there is no exact science here as well, but this review found studies showing a positive effect when reducing training volume by 41 to 60% during the tapering period. So that's a quite steep reduction in how much you train. And that might be why many people like myself struggle to actually do this, because I love training. And just the thought now that I'm going to train so little the next 7 days leading up to my next ultra stresses me out a bit. But should you also reduce the intensity in your training during the tapering period? It's a common assumption that you should dial down both the intensity and the volume of your training during a taper, but that doesn't seem to be what the evidence suggests. Research shows that keeping up the intensity and including some quality workouts is crucial for getting that peak shape you're looking for in a taper. For example, this study looked at two different tapering strategies for middle distance runners, one with high intensity but low volume, and another with low intensity and moderate volume. The results revealed that only the low volume, high intensity taper effectively boosted the performance for the runners. Before I share an example of how I design a tapering period, here's a quick summary to help you find your optimal taper and get the most out of your body in your next race. A taper period should be between 7 and 21 days, depending on what you find works for you and the race you're running. Reduce your training volume by around 50% of your usual training amount during the taper, but keep the intensity in your training. Test out different tapering models and find out what works for you. Because remember, we're all different and will respond differently to different tapering protocols. So to put all this that I've talked about into an example, here's a 2-week tapering period I have designed for one of the 5K training programs I've made. This particular program is designed for someone training at the peak of the program before the tapering period starts, just over 6 hours per week. And as you can see, I gradually dropped the volume this second last week to 4 hours, and then on race week, just under 4 hours of training, including the race. But I keep these key workouts and the intensity of them, just lowering how many reps and how hard those are compared to earlier in the program. Here I have the last tougher workout. I also had some strides on these easier short runs leading into the race to get that neuromuscular activation while still training so much less that you should end up on race day with fresh legs ready to PB. If you want to check out this particular training program or all the other training programs I have created, you can click here. Either way, good luck with your tapering, train smart, have fun, and I will see you in the next video.